the movie Armageddon?
Yes.
With Bruce Willis.
Mm-hmm.
Cho. And they're like these drillers. And they all had like kind of messed up lives. But all they really knew how to do was drill.
Come on, Jesus.
They knew how to drill. All right. And the world kind of thought them of as nothing, just like, they're just drillers. And last night, God kept, Cho, giving me this picture, and he keeps telling me about this Armageddon, and he keeps reminding me of that movie, and how, well, that movie, they went to space. Like, they went to space. They were granted to go to space, where most people, like, where you had to have like all this training, and you had to have all the credentials and all this stuff, but all they knew how to do was to drill. But they were granted to go where, like, no man's gone before. Like, they were granted to go there because they knew how to drill. God was showing me last night that he was raising up a remnant of people that know how to go really, really deep in God. And then, whoa! They were drillers. They were drillers. Because these in that movie, like, they like took no thought for their life. Like, they had an assignment. And their assignment was, we're gonna drill. And they knew that if they didn't go deep, and they didn't do, like, go deep, and it was gonna cost them their lives, it could cost them their lives, that the world would be destroyed, and all those they love would be destroyed.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh! Jesus!
I just felt like God was saying that he has a remnant of drillers that are going to save the world from destruction. And that we're a part of that remnant. And then that it's way, way bigger. It's way, way bigger than you think. And everybody doesn't know how to drill. But I felt like that God's gonna take things that the world would say, that's just foolishness, and those, that's, and he's gonna use it to save the world. So what we just did was drilling.
Yeah.
And God just says, go deeper. Go deeper into my heart. Go deeper. Go deeper. And I just feel like there's so much more that God's going to add on to that, but I don't know what it is yet. All I know is God just keeps saying, this is way bigger than what you think. This is way bigger than sunburn encounters. This is way bigger than abundant joy. This is way bigger than Bokey. This is way bigger than Laura Mock. This is way bigger than Cathy and Greg Boy. This is way bigger than this is way bigger. This is way bigger. But I want to tell you, God says you He says, you know how to drill. That's a really, really good thing. Everybody doesn't know how to drill. So I just looked up the name of the asteroid in the movie, Armageddon, of course. And it was Dottie, I guess, which is the diminutive of Dorothy. And Dorothy means gift of God. And I feel like the Lord is saying, this might be like a sneak preview of what Bo is talking about tomorrow, but that asteroid called out the drillers.
Yeah.
Called was a time marker of the end times. Yeah. This is the end of times. But it was the moment that every person on earth was going to die together.
Right. Yeah.
And it called out the drillers who said, not that way.
Yeah.
And the gift of God, which is the Holy Spirit, the gift of the Father is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Called out the ones that everybody had overlooked. So it's another way. It's another way. We're all going to die, but we're going to die to ourselves.
And Cathy, this keeps happening. It happened last night, but I cannot believe you said Armageddon. I'm serious. I thought I shared it with you. Maybe I didn't with you, but the Lord spoke to me mightily last week because, you know, like, I actually went into the movie and I scrolled to the very end of the movie to the scene because I saw it in the spirit and I knew the Lord was going to speak to me. But the very end of the movie, whenever Bruce Willis, you know, the rest of the guys that are ready to die for everyone, they didn't quite have the same skill set that he had, but there was a moment in the movie where Bruce Willis like went down and it was like that last moment. Whenever he made the decision, I'm going to die for everybody, you know, and they had to let him go. They had to get out of there or they would have been killed. But his purpose was because he loved his daughter and the other guy was the daughter's husband. But do you remember how I keep saying to you, Cathy and Greg, how I keep seeing this moment in the spirit that is so powerful, and it's this blind faith of not knowing what we're getting ourselves into. It's dark. You can't see anything, but you're following Jesus. And God took me to that very scene because he knew he was going to die. I mean, he made the decision to die to save the world. And in that moment, what it felt like to say yes to saving the world. And God showed me, you know, that's what Jesus did. Jesus did that very thing. But he showed me Jesus first. But then, I mean, he even, like, showed me my daughter, because there's a sacrifice, you know? There's a sacrifice going after Jesus. You have to give things up. I mean, people don't understand. Your family might not understand. But at the very end, you know, he was able to see. He was able to have that conversation with his daughter over the thing. And they like looked at each other's eyes. And he said, I love you, you know? And she said, Dad. She said, you thought I was always ashamed of you, but I want you to know, I want to be just like you. And I felt like that's how the disciples felt whenever Jesus left, you know? Like, I want to be just like that. I want to be just like that. And the Lord said, die daily. Die daily. Die to your own will. Die to yourself. Die daily. And you're going to bring life to everybody around you. But, I mean, this is not an easy thing. This thing that we're saying yes to is no light and easy thing. I mean, dying daily is not easy. It's not. It's painful. It's painful. And I wept all morning. There's power in my hands.
Yeah.
I wept all morning. I was even hearing, like, the song I saw by the Spirit. And I had so much healing, you know, like, because of Kaya and just, like, faith that, you know, this is an awesome honor for us to die for this gospel. And I'm going to be honest, I think some of us may actually die for the gospel. I believe that. And it is the greatest honor. So anyway, Cathy, it was the Lord. And in the spirit, whenever we say yes to that saving the world and us with that feeling of we don't know what's going to happen. We're going down there. We may die. We may not make it. We don't know what it's going to look like. It's dark. It's scary. You're facing your biggest giants. You're facing things that you never thought in a million years you'd have to face. But we're doing it together. And it's blind faith and that feeling of, yes, we're doing it. Yes, 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 yes. Hallelujah. Jesus is a hero, but you guys are heroes. You guys are heroes. Every time you say no to the flesh, every time you say yes to Jesus, every time you say not my will, but thy will be done, you're bringing life to everyone around you. And in that is a fresh anointing. In that is the fresh, God's going to give you things to say. Do you understand? God's going to give you a voice. He's going to anoint you with that fresh presence of the Lord so that when you speak, people encounter God. Just like what happened with Brian. You know, I saw him dying daily. I saw it in the spirit. He dies. He dies so that we can all encounter Jesus.